Vicky Ngari Wilson. I started a petition to return the Ethiopian Maqdala treasures. During this period, I have been completely fascinated with Queen Terenusha's story. There's not much about her. A few weeks ago, Professor Nick Thomas at Cambridge Museum of Archaeology and Anthropology, we had an interview from the art newspaper. It was a fascinating conversation about why are African artifacts in museums, and he's kindly invited me to come and look at these amazing treasures, which are actually Queen Terenusha's garments that I've never really been displayed at the V&A. Is that correct?
That's right.
Now, can you just tell us a little bit more about what you actually do here at Cambridge MMA?
This museum was founded in the 1880s, and the reasons why it was founded are in a sense a bit different to the reasons it exists now. We have the privilege of caring for all sorts of extraordinary human creations from all over the inhabited world. We make them accessible through exhibitions, but it's really important to us that the whole range of the collections, including material that's in storage, is actively used.
My role as collections manager is I look after all the objects. I work out where they go, I work out how to make them visible, how to make them accessible to people both in the UK and across the world. If people want to come to see them as you are today as a researcher, I make that happen.
Right.
And what my role is to make it accessible, to make it work, but I look after both the objects and the people who want to work with them. So it's really varied, but it's fascinating and I love it.
And for me, this is so much more grand and regal than the dress that is actually at the V&A. Okay, so now we have the Kenyan artifacts. So I'm going to invite Rachel to come and have a conversation with me. And come in.
Hiya.
Hi. So, okay, let's just jump straight in. Which era are these from?
These are from the Kikuyu people out in Kenya, East Africa.
Of course.
Yep, as you know very well.
I'm Kikuyu. Kikuyu are a Bantu tribe. And we are the most dominant tribe in Kenya.
Yep. So. We have a variety of material from Kenya, which was part of the British Protectorate, and that's where some of these material came from. So some dates back to the early sort of 20th century. So we have material which came to us in 1906. It's really intriguing because you have that one from the 1950s,
mm-hmm.
and this, which came to us in 1909. This is the one from Jean Fisher. Traders would come throughout the Africa and Pacific. They'll bring big cards of beads, and women would select what they wanted from them.
Where's this from? Which year is this from?
This is again is 1906, so this is quite early one. This again is by from Hind, the colonial officer.
Yeah, so a married woman would carry one of these in their forehead after she's married. Well, you see Kikuyu women now when they, I know my grandmother, when she looked after all my mom and her sisters, and she would sell fruit, she would carry a bag exactly like this, filled with fruit on her forehead. And it makes sense if you think about it. Like your head is the strongest part, and you've got your back that's...
Yeah, and it leaves your hands free for everything else.